Welcome back. Now, according to reports, federal government has plans to stop the importation of rice in the next 2 years. However, stating that the policy would not be enforced until we've developed local industry to maximally produce local consumption. The governor of Zamfara State stated that we have the potential, we have the human resources, we have the arable land to grow rice. In the next 2 years, we will not need to bring rice from outside Nigeria. We're going to ban it. Mm. What are your thoughts on it? It's your view. Let it count. You can call us on 070-8066-8014. You can tweet to us at TVC_ENT and please hashtag your view. Now, rice obviously is a staple food. Everybody eats rice. Mm. That means you can't even go without almost some families without in a day, at least once or twice. In the week is almost every time. So if they now ban it, now let's look at the options in the market. We have the local options, we have international. Most of us eat the international option because we want this Thai rice,
I disagree. A lot of people actually prefer ofada rice. And when you go to parties, people actually demand for ofada rice, which is our locally grown rice. The thing is, for me, if you ban this importation, I think people should have a choice. Personally, I think people should have a choice. What you should do is flood your market with Nigerian grown rice. When you see Nigerian grown rice selling for 2,000, 1,000, and then the imported rice is 11,000, which one will you buy?
The 1,000.
You will go to and buy the 1,000. So there's no need to ban it. There will be no need to ban it. Because it will be those bringing it by themselves, they will stop because nobody will be buying their rice.
There was a time I was trying to go healthy in my house, one time, some months back. I went to go and buy off of that rice. And I said, we're no more using this local imported rice. I bought the ofada rice. I cooked it. I ate it alone. Nobody followed me to eat that rice because
taste buds are already used to the foreign rice.
That's what I'm saying. Even I had guests in the house and they wondered, don't you have no more rice? Because I had brown rice in my. I cooked brown rice. It was actually brown rice. Brown rice is ofada rice.
Yeah, so ofada rice is brown rice.
So I cooked brown rice and they didn't eat it with me. In fact, till tomorrow is still there. The remaining is still there.
But
not eating it.
If you're already used to having soda on a regular basis, and then they
soft
say
drinks, right?
And then they say to you that the healthy thing to do is to only drink water. I will tell you my personal example. I can't take only water. I must mix apple cider vinegar to give it some taste because my taste buds are already used to having soda. So because you're used to having your white rice the way it is, ofada rice may be difficult for your family members to adapt, but if you keep at it, they will get used to it and start eating it.
And there
now,
is no reason.
When I went on a diet, YK, the only rice I ever ate was ofada rice. I love it, especially because I even know that it's healthy, it has more fiber and all of that. Mm-hmm. So why would I now be looking for Uncle Jumoke rice?
Besides, it's not every stew you use for ofada rice. There's a way you make its own.
That's one that has too much oil. That palm oil, but that's also eating too much oil. First of all, listen. Oh, there's too much drama. To enjoy our fried rice, they say put all the palm oil and everything.
Is it compulsory?
We can take that.
No.
Let's assume our fried rice. There is no reason why we cannot produce rice that is like
Thai rice.
There's no reason.
Can we produce Thai rice?
Yes.
You can.
Where?
Up north.
Up north where?
We are up north.
Shebi!
Although the farm rice is up north, but I don't know the rice.
No,
the
don't,
rice
it doesn't
in my village
have to
is ofada rice.
Ofada rice.
Now, the implication of this ban is what we call smuggling.
Yes,
I live close to the border and I see massive smuggling. There's no how, even when the ban was major during the last administration, that rice was available in the market for 11K. Imagine that there was no ban. I'm sure it would be affordable.
Like 7,000.
Like 7,000, 8,000.
You people, let me tell you. Have you tasted this? There are a few brands.
Chinese rice, I
believe. What's Chinese
brands?
That Chinese one is fantastic. It is. When you cook it.
Yeah, that one is basmati rice.
No, there's basmati rice. There's different. There's when you make it with jollof rice. Mm. There's this taste. It has this silky taste. And you're like, you feel like it's not the same thing as what we have here.
Morayo, this is why we are saying we should face agriculture properly. But when you face agriculture properly, you will bring people to learn how to make, if this is why how your taste buds
Malaysia. Is it Malaysia or what's this country that came here? to pick our palm nuts and went to plant. They now import palm oil from them.
Thank you.
This country.
Because we are the ones that grow palm oil.
Exactly.
But we still now import it.
Import palm oil from
palm kernel, sorry. Palm we are the ones that grow palm kernel. But we now import it.
They took our palm kernel, the palm nuts, and went to, you know,
what
to make soap, to make all kinds of things.
The moment,
let us develop our agriculture.
And our chocolate drinks. We're the ones who produce the cocoa.
Yes. Thank you.
We will import the chocolates. How? Why?
Oyinbo, do you know that Oyinbo, they cannot do without chocolates? Chocolates. Let
so
me say
they
it.
Must import our cocoa.
Proper English. Chocolate. They can't do without chocolate. Oyinbo cannot do without chocolate. They must eat chocolate. And so that is, there is no reason why our cocoa, we should not determine the price of cocoa. Because
globally.
They cannot do without, globally. That's what Nkrumah did, that they removed Nkrumah as a president of Ghana, because Nkrumah bought all the cocoa in West Africa and stored it. And when Oyinbo started looking for cocoa, Nkrumah said, I beg, I'm the only one that has cocoa. All the cocoa. And he said, okay, this is the price I want it. I want it at 80 naira. Take it or leave it. They had to buy because
at this price.
Oyinbo, if they don't eat cocoa, they will die.
Okay, no, they will die. Let's go back to rice. To the matter of rice. Now, the truth is that I think I have a call. Comrade Adele, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Good morning.
Good morning. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Well, my contribution to what you just told us about your cooking of rice at home and how people have refused to eat it, I think it has to do with the way those rice are prepared. And, you know, normally in Nigeria, people are used to just cooking rice, cooking stew, and the stew remains the way it is for a longer time. And when you go to nice hotels and eat these, you find that I have varieties of new varieties of ways in which people prepare this food. I'm an advocate that we should grow what we need and export what order needs. And I think, like it has been said, the government should invest massively in agriculture. But you must not be quick to forget that many of these produce are also genetically induced. And many of it also cause a lot of health problems. And if you go abroad, you find out that veggie food, natural food are more expensive. And we have abundance of such opportunities that we can tap into in Nigeria. And I think, like, you guys should also try to bring on board people that can teach others on how to make varieties of this food and how to also let it look very enticing to the children, to the family. But yes, I can use a fried rice in a very unique way, and by using it,
use it to make fried rice.
All right, before you go, I know you're the former chairman of Amuwa Dofing, right?
Yes.
So now you are. We've always talked on this show about how to get the various local government to start producing something within. As the former local government chairman, what do you think we could have done better to actually improve our economy by looking within, especially in the local government, because the state can do, the federal can do, but we can actually find something within. Because if we had started producing locally, maybe rice, beans, or maybe our economy would be different. So as a former chairman, what did you do, or what do you think we can do going forward as a local government internally to help our economy? Let me just throw that at you, since I know that you're the former chairman. Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Yes, well, okay.
Going forward, I'm very thankful to God that one of my products is seated with you. She served in the local government with me, the lady covering her head.
Nima, okay.
And you know, one thing about the local government in Lagos is that we have different peculiarities. For instance, in Amuwa Dofing, our lands are not in abundance. We have a lot of developed space there. And at these varying areas, the soil, the topology of the soil is not very unique for various varieties of crops. But despite that, we still make use of some part of the 6th Avenue working with the Fagamo to grow vegetables, and we also taught people on how to do some little animal husbandry. And all of that, particularly in switch farming and all whatnot.
Fantastic.
But if you go to Ikorodu, Ekpe, and all of those areas, local government also did a lot, like it. And I think the capacity, like as also people, the capacity of local government staff is also being increased. You find a lot of civil servants that are employed to work in the agri department, and many of them are not agri-based. But because of the fact that the need for job is very there, and local, I mean, the Lagos State government has done a lot in this regard, particularly from the Ministry of Agriculture,
all right,
teaching people on how to go on self farming and using the little space that they have to expand on all of this, and to the extent that they also work with other state government to provide land for them. And basically, it's about education.
Comrade, sorry to disturb, because I know I don't, there are lots of people that want to call in, but let me ask a quick question. Do you agree with the ban on rice?
No.
You don't?
I concur with what Mr. Yeni said.
Okay, I agree.
That you should open up for competition. People should decide on what they want to do.
Yeah.
So you can force the price down if you invest massively and make our own local rice very abundant, available, and of course, very uniquely presentable for our people, to the extent that they go for our local produced rice.
Yeah. Thank you so much, comrade.
You want people to buy our rice, and you don't.
Two things I agree with him: the opening up the markets, competition. When there's no demand, it's healthier. Now, when there's no demand, they will stop importing because people are choosing the local one. Secondly, the health part. Our local ofada is not genetically modified. So it's not all this your rice that you're saying is sweet, is something.
Not
all those Chinese ones.
Prove
you
it.
You don't know.
Prove it.
No, but because
look
of
at all those
land.
Fruits. Look at that.
We know the fruits.
They're all genetically modified.
Yes.
And they're very sweet.
Maybe,
and me, I eat them. I don't know whether they're going to be.
Maybe you should teach me how you're boiling your own rice. Because maybe I'm not getting the right. I'm not boiling it properly.
Why? Was it not sweet?
I don't know. There's just something about it. They're just very bland.
Maybe you put too much water.
No, I don't. I don't put too much water.
Even being bland is tasty.
It's tasty.
Because the way there's the one from my place. I don't know what the one the father, but the one from my place has this way where you chew it. There's this chewy fulfillment that
really?
You get.
And then it's not even soggy.
Somebody got me as father over the weekend. It was too soggy. I mean, it was just
the only difficult part
soggy.
Is that you have to clean it.
You have to
it
pick
like
this. Hey.
That's like that picking pan. In 2015, I start picking pan. I start picking rice. Basti, good morning, please. Can I pick
Hello.
It and get...
Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
I'm a first-time caller.
Yay.
Yeah, I appreciate your contribution on the subject. My contribution is that rice importation and importation of other agri products ought to have been banned long time ago. We have to be serious about our country and its development. Mm. And in my view, the ban of importation of agri products should be part of policy to stimulate the economy via agri activities. And it's as simple as that. There are other countries that have done it. China, even in West Africa here, you have Ivory Coast. You have a local product called acheke, which is made from cassava. They are not even importing it to Europe.
Wow.
Yeah,
so pretty much we have
by that process reduced the taste for imported rice.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Mr. Basti. We're going to take a quick break now. When we come back, we'll have our guest on, still talking about rice importation. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Now, as you know, rice is Nigeria's number one staple food. And according to the former agricultural minister, Akinwumi Adesina, he said Nigeria spends over 350 billion naira annually importing rice. And this is a result of our inability to meet demand locally. What will be the implication on the ban on rice importation? All right, staying with us here is, or joining us here, is a farmer, business expert, and a former youth ambassador, right?
Yes.
For agriculture, Mr. Adeni Shalabumi. Welcome to the show.
Yeah, good morning.
You can call us on 0708-066-8014. You can tweet to us at TVC_ENT and please hashtag your view. Now, there was a tweet that came in concerning.
Yes.
Waike, do you want to read that tweet for us?
Okpawoluwa tweeted a tweet from Ben Bruce. He says, Bembu says, I don't understand why FG reversed the restriction on rice imports. It's not good for our farmers, and Nigerians won't die if we eat local rice.
Yes, yes. I overheard you saying something about the ban.
Yeah.
We have this 6 years ago, we have it, and until 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, the custom board said, through the land border, I want to open it up, let rice comes in. Why he did that is, okay, you want to like increase the generated
revenue,
but the challenge is you're actually killing us. Let me give you a scenario. 6 years ago, you said, okay, you guys go ahead, go and start farming, start doing rice, because the government wants to be, Nigeria wants to be rice sustainable. We don't want to bring in rice, but they are not cutting it off outrightly, like a quota thing. Start as it's going up, we are bringing in. At the end of the day, we'll be able to do 50-50, 60-40, 80-20, and at the end of the day, the local rice will dominate. Now, a lot of people have invested a fund or money into the processing line, marketing, to the whole value chain. All of a sudden, you are now saying, okay, open up the border. That means you are legalizing
going by what the caller said,
yes,
isn't that healthy for you, competition, so that you know the, no, so they can then choose.
Actually, you are talking about they stopped the ban. There was an existing ban through land border.
Yes.
The guy now, the custom boss, lifted it that, okay, no more ban.
His excuse was that because there's not sufficient
that despite
rice,
the fact that it's banned,
so people are now smuggling.
No, that despite the fact that it was being banned, they were smuggling it, and they are not paying fee.
Was the monetary
okay, fine, bring it in, let's pay
the duties.
Okay. Now, the government, after that, you know, there was noise from farmers, from the Miller Association. They now say, okay, guys, relax, in 2 years' time, we'll ban.
Okay.
Yeah, but can I just ask you this question? Please, let me ask this question. You see, the farmers are not meeting up the demand, which is why they are bringing in the rice. I, at one time, said, it's only ofada I want to eat.
Okay.
By the time I bought one small ofada like this, that was about 5,000 naira, as to the bag that I will buy of imported rice, what my senses will talk to me, I will go to the cheaper one, which is the imported one. The Nigerian locally made one is too expensive.
Okay.
So what you should be saying is to the government, farming, I believe, for now, should be heavily subsidized. Just as they are subsidizing oil, farming should be heavily subsidized by the government so that you can start to produce enough rice for all of us.
Yes. Okay, good. I don't want us to complicate this issue. Let's take it step by step.
Me too, I'm ready.
Let me digress a little bit. Mm-hmm. You have your bead. Mm. You know, my grandmother, my great-grandmother do wear bead in Nigeria.
Mm. Mm.
Now you have your imported bead and different kind of beads.
Mm.
Do you understand now?
Mm.
What happens to the former bead?
Nowhere to find.
The thing is, the clamor for foreign things is actually killing us in this country. Now, there's no enable environment, madam. I don't have the reason why I should leave banking job or any job and go into the farm. After I finish producing this particular product, I'm in the market competing with a product coming from China, and which is, you can imagine eating plastic rice.
True.
Chinese producing plastic rice. At the end of the day, they have the facility, the machinery to bring something more better, not in terms of quality and earthwise, something more beautiful and appealing than what I'm doing here.
Technically modified.
Now, as a farmer, when you talk about fada, that is one thing that Ogun State should look at. The word of fada came from that zone.
Exactly.
Now we have Abakaliki rice, we have Igbemo rice from Ekiti, we have different Boko rice and this thing. These are our local rice.
Never heard of this rice before.
There are a lot of them. But when you eat them in party, the branded name is ofada. Now, this same rice that we have in this country can be as polished, as clean, as branded as anything. You just need a destoner to destone. You need a polish machine to polish it.
It's what I'm
now,
saying.
Who will go to the farm? An average farmer is old, is tired. You have to start pushing birds. And there's a technology whereby you can just spray your farm and birds will not come in. Yeah, there are a lot of things that is wrong.
That is what I'm saying.
Reality, what the federal government is saying. If they're saying in 2 years, they will ban. Is it not enough time for the farmers now, someone like you,
madam,
to seek to seek the necessary investment that you need and boost production?
He can compete in 2 years time. Like,
he doesn't have, where is he going to get the money?
Where will I get the investment? Let's
not get to that
point. Let's start it again. I want to really, I overheard you saying a lot of things about rice. You know, this thing is a bit complicated, once again. Now, 6 years ago, there was a ban through the land border. We have different borders. Land border. The meaning is that if you come through, if it comes through to the sea, you will pay the tariff, you pay, there's a weaver and everything for those people bringing it into the country. Now the land border was like, okay, stop bringing it in now, so that the local farmers can go into it.
Okay.
And a lot of people came on board during the last dispensation. The last minister was really did a lot of things. They brought new varieties. Varieties that you can plant twice in a year, like during dry season and wet season. Then they started working on different, Lagos State also did a lot of stuff, bringing machines. They started working on, and people were keen into it. A lot of people were coming into it. Along the line, the 6 years we are producing now. Actually, I brought some rice for you ladies. Beautiful branded rice. Not cooked. Raw. Beautiful one.
I'm
now,
very hungry.
Everybody was like in my zone. I'm my family is in Ogun State. I'm based in Ogun State. In my local government, as Iwekoro local government, the farmers there, they are into rice. What I did on my own little, you see, when you talk about government, government has a lot of headache. There are a lot of sectors that government have. Agric is just, it's so crucial, but it's so tiny and minute to them because they believe that you can survive on your own. I left Ogun 5 a.m. I almost came here late. The roads are bad. So there are a lot of things they can do, but they cannot even look at that. Now, this man at Into Rice, what I did is I told them, okay, do this rice. They cannot do in large quantity because the stress is much. Everything is changing.
They are old.
I'm a youth. I'm young. Okay, I just want to round it up.
Okay, round
now, when what we did is, okay, guys, go and farm. I will buy back from them. I bought it back from them. Instead of them taking it, I bought it back from them and I gave them money to farm. They are doing another one now. I gave them money to farm. That's why I could get the process one I'm talking about now. That some other people are buying and we are sending. This rice also, we export a lot. Even our local distributor, on a small scale.
Let me come to
now,
you.
young, you know, old farmers doing it here and there, they cannot do in large quantity. The encouragement is
even
not. 6 years ago, you encouraged us. Madam, please.
Hang in there.
Okay.
I'm waiting for you to land. I'm not hitting you land. So let me just jump in for a second.
Okay.
Even if you produce in large quantity.
Yes.
The truth is, if I compare a Thai rice.
Okay.
Whatever, maybe Chinese
father.
Rice,
okay.
Your father, it's still not very attractive.
No.
Now, what must we do? I'm asking now.
Okay.
To make a father or a balikiliki, what do we do to make it attractive enough so that when a Thai rice is, when we see it and the Thai rice, we can choose, aside from pricing is a factor, but even because I wouldn't buy an ofada rice like that. What can we do to brand that one better so that we can compete
internationally
with an international brand?
Okay, let me. From the first thing is the body language of the government.
Okay,
there must be a policy that supports local content.
Exactly.
You understand?
Thank you.
Something that supports local content. Here we don't support what we do. Now, when you talk about our own rice, the investment on this is heavy. You are talking to a former local government chairman the other time. A local government can invest into the processing center, modernized processing center, whereby farmers bring in their rice. All they just have to do is bring the rice and get payment immediately. It can be through e-wallet or payment into their account. There is a standard price for every kg that has not been de-ossed. Okay, when you bring your rice, it's 1,000 naira per so bag. So I can bring my 50 bag. I'm sure that somebody is buying. I can go and borrow money and plant. So I will just bring the rice to the center and you are paying me immediately. It might not be cash. I get the alert. I'll go back to the farm and do. And when you see me doing good, I'll tell you, my friend, go and get that land and farm because the government are buying from us, or a private entity is buying from us. Then they will now process The machines are not too expensive. I cannot buy the machine. Alaji buy the machine. This guy buys the machine. At the end of the day, we don't have that money. But there should be a center. Fantastic. Private sectors can come in, mop it up, process it, bag it, and release it to the market.
I was going to say that Osho State had such a program on ground where they assisted farmers to, you know, get their products to the market. They were buying from the farmers and, you know, using it for their state one meal per day for in their schools.
Awesome.
Did you as a farmer ever take advantage of such?
He's in Ogun State.
No, I'm in Ogun State.
That's
and
an example.
I'm even hearing that for the first time. But in Ogun State, I'm working on a proposal. In Ogun State, this thing is simple.
Okay, I think I like the format. But we have to take a quick commercial. When you come back, we'll start with YK.
Simple.
Stay with us. We'll be right back. Fantastic. Welcome back. So we still have our guests, and I think I like the last point you made, which makes a lot of sense, where the farmers, yes, they can't afford the big processing machines, but there should be that center everybody goes to. Now, people who are looking to invest in agriculture can take that as an opportunity to actually buy these huge machines, either for fruits, for vegetables, for rice, every agricultural product.
Processing and packaging to give it a finished
look. So that finished product is competitive enough in the market.
This is what I'm trying to say. Because he spoke about polished rice. Yes. When you get polished rice, you will not have those things that are inside.
You know our rice is like oval shape.
Yes.
When you polish it, it's as sharp as the other rice. And it will take the brown color away. So you have a clean rice.
This is what I'm saying. If local government, or whoever invested and the market is flooded with our own locally produced rice at a cheaper rate, nobody will buy that imported rice. So if you like, open the border. If you like, nobody, because again, we have enough
here. Let me take this call.
And look, I won't try to buy your father. And I couldn't afford it. So take the call.
Let me take this call. Olaleko, are you there?
Yeah, I'm there.
Good morning. Please go ahead.
All right, yeah. What I'm just trying to say is, there's two things we have to look at. You see, Ofada rice and the imported rice. The imported rice, the process of that rice is shorter than Ofada rice. The imported rice, it produces mostly chemicals, and the process is shorter. But the Ofada rice, it takes long. That is why it's expensive than imported rice. You know, if you come to UK here, it's like going to Tesco, Asda, Sainsbury. Most of their product is cheaper because most of them, they are
mass production.
Chemicals.
But no, it's mass production.
See the produce by organic.
It's not chemical, it's mass production.
If you really want to buy organic food, organic product, you go to Waitrose or Cadbury's. You see? So we have to look at, you have to know one thing. Most of our things is mostly organic.
But do you get to buy your father there in London? Do you get buy your father?
Well, we don't really get it. You know, this UK here, we use chemical food. That is why, to be honest,
you can get
it. You find it in African store, I'm sure.
No, really?
You'll just be
okay,
I just want to say something. Because he's saying it's all
chemicals.
And I disagree. Let me tell you something about one thing. When I was touring with the band, one thing I noticed is that farmers are the richest. Abroad, in France,
yes.
They are the richest people. When you are a farmer, you are a lord, you are a rich person. Here, a farmer is a poor person. That is the difference. They support their farmers. You see farmers all year round. They are collecting grass, collecting this, collecting. They are supported. They are fully supported by the government.
YK, when he says chemically produced, and hers is a little bit more difficult. You are disagreeing with him to say that they're not chemicals. Maybe they're fertilizers and things, the chemicals put there. Now, rather than rice growing in 9 months, that we were waiting for 9 months for it to grow, their own has grown in 2 months.
Actually,
now, I do agree with him that
he says they have new. I'll talk to him. Listen to him properly.
When you fight, let me take Mercy first. Mercy, are you there? I'm so sorry, Mercy. Yes, Nima.
Now, what I hear from what you're saying is that the 6 years ban had made you guys go into investment.
It's really encouraged a lot of people to go into it.
Lifting this ban now is going to be a major loss to the farmers.
Already? That's what already within the last two
but
weeks.
Nima, what are they going to do in 2 years that they didn't do in 6 years? They had 6 whole years now, to get to that point that we're hoping they'll get to in 2 years.
This is what did you do in 6 years? Recently, what I hear from what he's saying is that in 6 years, encourage them to invest money.
A lot of people have come
now
on board.
They are investing, they have products.
The production is a bit higher now. Mm-hmm. A lot of people are coming, have actually come on board. We have different, from two processing centers, it has moved to almost 27 standard processing centers. Now, governments cannot do this thing alone. Government need a sustainable policy. Exactly. These policies are just not favorable. Somebody is saying this, this person is saying this. The custom now is lifting a major thing that will affect every one of us. I don't think the EE has the capacity to do that.
He doesn't have the statute.
Now, the right to do that.
Yes.
In 6 years, a lot of people have come on board. Processing center, a lot of people are coming into it. Now you are opening the border again. Presently, imported rice is like 7,000. Our rice is like 12,000 naira.
Let me take Shagun.
Now,
Shagun, are you
we
there?
Are moving up.
Shagun, why are you there? Good morning.
To set us back.
Good morning, Morayo.
Good morning, sir. Go ahead.
Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
I just wanted to say to the gentleman in the studio and, you know, everybody else that is listening, everything, just like he's rightly said, everything will be done for us by government, you know. And Nigerians, we make this mistake a lot. If only government will do this. I am a consultant, right? I'm a financial business development consultant. And I know that there is investment out there. There are investors out there who have money looking for good projects to put their money into. What you guys need to do as farmers, you know, talking about that, for instance, that processing center, fantastic idea. Why don't you put it together? Put a business plan in place. Show to investors that in 3 years, in 5 years, in, you know, whatever time it will take, you will recover your funds with this amount of return on investment. And you'll find that you'll get the money. So the government may be in terms of tax holidays, in terms of, you know, policy framework to help support what you are doing privately.
Fantastic.
Yes, maybe government can do that. But generally...
Fantastic. Let's see.
There's this Yusuf Sani who says, in Thailand or US, the cost of production per hectare is 100% cheaper than in Nigeria because of their improved seeds. I don't know about their improved seeds, but I know that cost of production there is far cheaper than it is here. It's difficult for the farmers.
GMO, Oluwabumi says, if we don't eat white rice, we won't die. Aggressive steps are needed to push this country forward. Less support. Ijoma Tobad says, Morayo, do you know that your father rice is essential to weight loss? I have for long stopped taking processed rice. Johnny says, for you to know, bag of import rice is 8,000 to 9,000. Our local rice is 12,000 because it's so rich. It is good to ban chicken rice also. Ademiloju says, can the local farmers meet the quality and quantity requirements, or they want it handed down to them? Jumi Wale says, banning of rice is as if you cancel subsidy on petrol without refinery. We need to have refinery for rice too.
Yeah.
Balale.
Your guest is really making sense, and I hope government or private sectors can help make it work. Kudos,
okay,
ladies.
Let me let you go,
okay,
sir.
Let me ask you this question. Let's just, for reckless imagination, let's assume we don't even have imported rice. Are we going to die?
No, we'll eat yam.
Let's leave that. Now, what we are saying is, we are ready, farmers, the encouragement is there. A lot of young people, graduates are coming into agri now, massively. Mm. Give us a policy that supports more people to come on board.
What would that policy say?
The meaning is enable environment.
Okay.
Policy that support 100% local content.
Okay.
There are some things you do. If I'm a governor of a state, I don't need to ban your rice. Yeah. That's why I'm still clamoring for the brand. You know, the God has given Ogun that name. Now, if I own Ofada, the Ofada is a town in my... I will build brand Ofada. I will make sure that I mop all the rice, give farmers a new variety seed, let them plant, we mop it and process it. And the gateway state is pushing out Ofada. There's a simple thing. Students in my universities, in my polytechnic, start getting doctors to talk about the end benefits of it. People will start leaving the imported thing.
Exactly.
And they will feed into it majorly.
This is
when
what
you
I'm
encourage
saying.
Social media is there. I want the likes of Linda, EKG, Omojua, all those people to start talking about
eating
the benefit
local.
Of okay. local.
So,
local
so even if they are bringing in
the rice, it's good for us now. If it's local. If it's local, so no, if no, I eat no, it now and I like right. it, I should say it on television.
It's just that I can't bring local. It on board because it's branded. You will fall in love with the packaging.
So I'll share the news that for that tomorrow,
madam, it's going to be an empire. You won't even want to eat it.
I'll cook it today.
Beautiful, well packaged. It's like a chopping bag.
Okay, I have to shake
you. Know, we are moving from the next level. What we are doing now is we are into production, processing, packaging, marketing. We're not waiting for government.
One last question.
My father government, if they give me an able environment.
If they are bringing these things,
we are going to do things.
One last question.
Nobody will buy the imported rice.
Yes,
how many years do you need to, for all the things that you have already put in place, for everything
to take over the market?
Actually, we are not saying they should ban outrightly.
Mm.
Thank you.
We're not saying they should ban this thing outrightly.
Let
don't
them
do counter policy. Some people have okay. invested a lot of money in the past 6 years. Let's sense. Continue like that. Don't allow the road through the land border. Let's continue like that. We are growing. We'll get to a stage that we will stop this thing naturally.
All right.
Thank you.
We have to end on that note.
Nah, I just what I'm just saying. We have to agree for these people to flood the market and then
we are ready. We are ready to flood.
I will cook that Ofada rice. Unfortunately, we can't show it on TV
want to buy
because it's branded. But I will cook it because I know Ofada rice. And me, personally,
maybe you are buying a bakaliki.
So I will buy your own. I mean, I will cook your own today. Mm-hmm. And I will tell people how it is.
No,
so
it's branded. It's lovely.
Now tweet this. Now tweet your brand.
You see, we need to start making recipes.
You don't need to make it. You can eat it.
You know why this thing is like this?
You can eat it with curry.
People should start, you know, the bloggers. They start doing something about
Can you use Ofada rice to do jollof rice?
Yes,
of course.
Really? Very nice. Fried rice, everything.
Fried rice. Yes.
Oh, you put carrot and everything inside your father.
Yes.
Rice.
Yes.
Madam,
he
says something.
We have to go. We have to go. All right.
You can eat it with salad.
Bye bye. See you tomorrow. I lost my voice to say bye bye. See you tomorrow.
Thanks.
Can you eat it with salad? Yeah.